It's Steve with Entering Into Space, and I wanted to go over a new process that I've learned here in PixInsight, or picked up here in PixInsight, for processing RGB data. Color. So that's color for you guys in Rio Linda. Miss you, Rush. Mega dittos, wherever you are. And in true Entering Into Space fashion, I'm always multitasking, so not only am I doing a processing video for you guys tonight, but I'm also in the process of imaging a new target. This is the Skull and Crossbones Nebula. Really low, but super cool. Here using the AnyDesk app. So enough of that. Let's get you out of here. Let's talk about why we came here. So the image that I chose is the Pleiades, the Seven Sisters. This is my luminance data. And let's do a screen transfer. This is just a preview stretch. You can see I got a pretty heavy gradients here on the luminance, but one thing I want to show you is when I stack this, you see how they don't line up? Nope. So our first thing is we're going to minimize these guys. It's the red data. Push that over here. Let's do a screen transfer function on our green data. And the blue ought to be popping. As you know, M45 or the Pleiades or the Seven Sisters, you pick, I don't care. It's got a lot of blue data in it. So this is about an hour and a half worth of 2 minute subs across the board. I think it's more like 2 hours. I can't remember. So because they're not lined up, we got to line them all up here. So we're going to use our luminance as our reference frame. We're going to come here to process, all processes, and we're going to go down to star alignment. We're going to drag our luminance over to our reference image. And then we're going to grab the red, green, and blue data. We're going to put that right here. And these three files are now going to align to this file. And all we have to do is hit apply global. And it's basically going to, I say basically a lot, get over it. It's going to create three new files that are aligned to the luminance data. And then they're popping in now. Ba, ba, ba. All right, ta-da, they're done. So we can close that tool. We can take these three guys here that we have highlighted and we can delete them. And now we have new registered, actually aligned frames to the luminance data. So let's do a quick preview with the screen transfer function. And what we're looking for is the image that has the worst offset artifact or stacking artifact. And it looks like it's going to be our red. We're going to crop this in anyway to kind of speed up the process. So I like to crop all these individually, and I like to do a background extraction individually before I get to combining. So let's come in here to process. Let's go down to geometry. Dynamic crop. And we're just going to hit the reset button here. That activates, puts an active box around the engine. Where in the world do these words come from? They're just dying to get out. Like, say engine. Dang, I'm saying it anyway. All right. So let's bring this in. I'm just going to bring this crop box in. You see how that little box pops up on the side there? Means it's ready to drag in. I'm just going to drag this one in here. Let me move the box around and get a decent frame. Something like that. Right about there. All right. And if you've watched this before, or if this is the first time you've seen it, I'm going to explain everything again. So basically, this box and everything about this box is now in data and information in this little triangle here. When I pull it out, all the information about this box, exactly where it is in the frame, is now all saved on this little instance. And we're going to drag that down and I put it in my little cubby. I'm going to close the tool. Yes. I'm going to drag it over, drop it on the image, cropped. Red's done. Let's drag it over on the green, cropped. Red and green, blue, you're getting it too. Done. And then luminance, we haven't forgot about you. Everybody gets a haircut. Bam. All right. So the next thing I want to do is a dynamic background extraction, meaning, see, I've got these bright corners, dark, all this here. I want to flatten that out. I want it to all be nice and dark all the way around. I don't want any gradients. And I'm going to use my red data. Actually, let's use the blue data because it has the most signal. All right. I'm going to show you a little different way to use background or dynamic background extraction. Make it bigger. Come here to process, background modelization, dynamic background extraction. So we're going to click the image to link the tool to the image. We're going to do a drop down list here in sample generation. Watch this. We're going to change our sample radius to 200. Yeah, 200. We're going to bump our tolerance up to 0.8. We're going to lower our minimum sample weight to 0.4. We're going to increase our smoothing factor to 0.6. And we're going to samples per row. We're going to drop that down to 4 since we're making our boxes so stinking big. We're going to hit generate. What? Look at how big those boxes are. But that's exactly what we want. We want nice boxes all the way around the edge. And these guys here, let's just move them. We're not going to delete them. We're just going to move them away from the image. Something like that. See that? And now we're going to come down here and we're going to come to target image correction. And we're going to choose division. Why? Because we have vignetting as what we have here. And division gets rid of vignetting the best. If we had super dark on this side and super bright on this side, that would be an additive gradient due to light pollution. So we would want to choose subtraction. But because we have vignetting, just kind of brighter corners and darker in the middle, we choose division. And we just hit the check mark. It's going to give us two files. It's going to give us our background. We can delete it. It's going to give us a new image. Slide that over and let's preview it. Big time difference, right? Awesome. Minimize it. I like those big old sample points. So now we're not going to delete the tool. We're going to take all them sample points. Everybody right here. All this data is now on this little instance. We're going to drag it over and drop it. Process 2. You can rename it if you want. We're just going to leave it process 2 because we know that's our background extraction. And we're going to close the tool. And let me close this ugly blue. And let's open up red. So now you got to do is just double click this instance and it populates the boxes. And you notice for some reason, when you do that, they're all just a little smaller. And if you are a PixInsight guru and can tell me why that happens, let me know. You also notice, guess what? It works the same. You also notice we got a box here that's not happy. So let's increase our tolerance. And then just click outside the box. Yep. See, he went from red to gray. Now he's green. He's happy. But our boxes are a little smaller and I had to adjust them all. It's not going to really affect the outcome. But I do want to drag this instance over and see how I'm going to drop it right here. And it says, do you want to change everything? Yes, you want to change it. Okay. So now let's just hit the check mark. Same thing. We get a background. We get a new image. Let's stretch it. Looks great. Minimize it. Red. Put a blue down here. I'm OCD. Let's close the tool. And because we drag that instance over here, now it'll replicate that. We're basically changed the structure of the emplacement of these boxes. So let's close the tool. Click yes. Close the ugly image. Let's see, what was it? Green is the one. The ones that say DBE are the ones that are done. So let's expand that. Remember, double click the instance. See, now our boxes, they're smaller, but they're all pushed out to the edge. Now let's click the check mark, preview it, man, 3 for 3, put you right here, close the tool, close the old image, open up our luminance has probably the worst gradients, let's double click it, Everybody's happy. Everybody's gray. So let's click the check mark here. Let's check our new image out. Ooh, love it. Let's push that up here. And now we are done with working on these images individually. So the next thing we want to do, and now we're going to dive in kind of to the reason that I wanted to create this video, is we're going to combine these into the color channel. So we're going to open up LRGB combination. Let's reset the tool, drag and drop, red, green, blue. Uncheck our luminance, and we're going to hit this apply global. And it's going to run through here, and it's going to combine those three into one channel or one image. Let's minimize that. So if you're not shooting mono and you're shooting one-shot color, DSLR, or dedicated camera, pretty much now we are the same. We're twinsies, okay? So the screen transfer function, I've said before, comes defaulted to have all the channels linked. So if we hit the preview, let's see what we see here. We're going to see an image that doesn't look too bad, honestly. You know, sometimes you'd see solid green or solid blue or solid red, but that just is going to require a background neutralization. But the reason that this looked pretty good with those channels linked is because we took the time to do a background extraction on the individual subframes. But we want to go through the standard process. We want to go ahead and neutralize the background. And the way we do that is we're going to zoom into this image and we're going to find an area of space that doesn't have any stars. And we're going to come to this little white box here, click it. Just going to draw a preview box, and we're telling PixInsight, hey, PixInsight, that's background. And sometimes that's hard if you got a ton of stars. I mean, you could really search, but this one's not too bad. So we're telling PixInsight that's background. This data is still linear. If I hit the F12 button, you see it goes black. So hit F12 again to stretch it. Stretch preview, that's all it is. We're gonna come up here to process, color calibration, background neutralization. Click it. So this little window here, we want to click it, and we have a drop-down list now. Click that drop-down list, and then we have to come in here, image 17 preview. This is image 17. This is our preview. Click OK. So this is real simple. Watch this. Drag and drop. Now you see the image changed a little bit. You see some of the green came out. You can hit F12 and then restretch it. Let's see what it looks like. Still got some green in there. We're going to kill off a little bit later. I know I use the word kill. All right, so now we want to do a color calibration. We want to calibrate the colors. We're going to do that simply by going process. Color calibration. Color calibration. Who would have thunk it? So once again, we need to designate what our background reference is. So same process, drop down list, preview one. Okay. We're not going to choose a white reference. We're going to let the whole image be our white reference, but we are going to turn off structure detection because we have nebulosity. We're not doing like a star cluster, or we have some nebula here we want to protect. So now that we have, it says white reference is basically our target image. We have told it what our background is. We've turned off structure detection, and now we're just going to apply the tool to the image. That looks a lot better. Let's hit F12. Let's restretch it for a preview. And we're going to turn off color calibration. So that has been background neutralized and color calibrate. So here's where I hated PixInsight as a one-shot color shooter before I got a dedicated AstroCam, and I was putting DSLR images through here. Is I'm like, this looks like crap. I mean, it looks okay, but it's super noisy, all right? Well, there's multiple ways to now stretch your image. Your image is linear, the data is linear, and you want to become non-linear. Kill the auto stretch. You could open up histogram transformation, open up a preview, and you can manually stretch this image. Just like if you're used to Photoshop, you see that? You can do that. You click accept. And now you click reset, and you just keep working that back and forth until you get an image like you like it. That's one way to do it. And that's what I'd used to do in the very beginning once I found out you could do that and not rely on the screen transfer function. But what we're going to do is we're going to go back one step. We're going to make this data linear again. We're going to leave that preview box set, okay? So we're going to leave that right there because we're going to use that for our next tool. Our next tool is called Masked Stretch. And that's the party. That's why we're here today. So we're going to come up here to process all processes. And M as in masked stretch. So we want to give it a background reference, same process. Click on this little square, image preview, click OK. Now, the target background comes to default at 0.125. I think that's a little dark for me, so I like to raise that up to like 0.4. It doesn't take much, people. And the clipping fraction, I like to take that to not 0.005, but 0.05. And that is really the only two things that I do. And I also increase the iterations to 120. So it uses a series of masks to basically stretch this image, but it really does a good job of preserving the colors. It's almost a little dark when it comes out. But we'll work on that and brighten it up some. So I'm going to kill the stretch preview. See, it's linear, so it went back or black, back to black. Is that a song? Back to black. AC/DC? I don't know, maybe. So let's just drag it over and drop it. And it's going to run through 120 iterations of stretching before it gets to a final image. 99%. Ah! Okay, so here we are, mass stretch. Minimize the tool. I don't know that we're going to use it again. But that's a pretty good looking image. The background's not blown out. You've got good color data, and we can work on this. And it's not done, trust me, because we still got to bring luminance to the party, okay? This is just your color data. So we got a little red up in here that we may have to work on maybe in Photoshop. See a little red right there? Probably didn't get completely wiped out when I was doing a background because I was trying to be fast for you guys because I know you guys get bored easy, but I'll deal with that later. So we can kill this preview, hit delete. So we got a really good color data, good strong color data in this. But let's brighten this up and try to separate the color and the bright spots from the background just a little bit more before we apply our luminance, because I'm going to show you how in the luminance application we can increase saturation. That rhymed. It was totally unintentional. So this little guy right here, this little rainbow with a side pop-out box thing, let's click it, and it's going to extract the luminance from this image. The light, just the light only. Black and white image. And let's give a little more separation between the light and the dark. So let's open up our histogram transformation tool. This is image 71 luminance. So that's what we have open. Let's open up a real-time preview. Let's reset the tool. So we're going to drag this middle slider over, brighten it up just a little bit, and we're going to clip the black a little bit more. Right there. I like that. Don't like that. Look, reset it. Minimize the tool, close the real-time preview, drag it over and drop it as a mask. You see how that works? And that's the thing. PixInsight, can you be a little less counterintuitive? Like, why would you do that? Like, why does that? There's no landing strip there. There's no, hey, place it here. Sorry. Okay, so let's minimize this. And let's right-click on the image, get a mask, and say show mask. Let's just say don't show mask. What do I know? So now we want to brighten this image a little bit and separate the color and the brightness of this image from the background. So let's open up our curves transformation tool. Click a real-time preview. Go into RGB. And it's simple. We're just going to create S curves. Like this. Pull it down. Click the square to accept it. That S curve has been applied to our image. Our screen transfer is showing it in the image and this again. So we just click the reset button. Let's do it one more time. Back up. Little S curve. Let's come to the saturation. We're just going to just give it a little pop. Let's grab this B component because we really want to pop that blue right there. Let's take that B component and pull it down. I like that. I like it. We're almost to the point with this star here. We're almost blowing that out. So we probably want to chill. You can start seeing the telltale signs of the ZWO, the little squares around the really bright star. So we're going to probably stop there. But one thing we're going to do is go right click, mask, invert mask. So now we're protecting all the bright spots and the background is vulnerable. Don't believe me? You don't believe me, do you? Watch this. Mask, show mask. Bam. Okay. Bright spots protected because they're red. Background is vulnerable. Mask, show mask. So let's open up another real-time preview. Click our RGB. Now watch this. If we click right in here on the space, right in here, see that? Let's click right here. It's telling you where your RGB levels are along this line. See that right there? So we want to anchor this line. Put a point here, put a point there. That means everything bright in this image is going to be anchored where it's at right now. When we bring that line down, we're not bringing it down too. We're not going to get rid of the work that we just did. So now we're just going to come right here about in the middle ways and we're just going to pull it down. Boop, just like that. Accept it. So the other thing I want to do now that I have the background vulnerable, I like that word, apparently, is if we zoom in here, we're going to see that, first of all, I got some really bad stars, but look at all this green. See, green is the noisiest data that you're going to get, no matter whether you're shooting mono or whether you're shooting one-shot color. Green is your noisy channel. So let's kill the green off in the background, okay? So let's come to process. Let's come down here into noise reduction. SCNR. What SCNR is comes default to is color remove green. Yeah, we're going to leave it 100%. Our brightness is still protected. Our background isn't. So let's just drag it over, drop it on the image. And now we got kind of a purpley background. That's fine because the luminance will cure that. But that's a whole lot better than green. Let's minimize the tool in case we need it again. So now if we come in here, a lot less green. A lot. Wish I would have fixed my stars though. Anyway, so I'm happy. Mask, right click on the image, mask, and we're going to remove the mask. Okay, we don't want it anymore. Now, if you come in here and you look at this image, looks good and we got good color data. Look at our stars. I mean, was one thing I always fought when I processed this in the first time. This is all my stars were blue. I didn't get this really good color variation between the stars. I mean, for crying out loud, whoa, that's too close. Look at this, like the whiteness of this star, but you get this one that's more orange. It's awesome. You know, that's what you're looking for in a good quality astrophotography image, is good star color. But you can see we got a lot of noise in here. So let's fix that. So let's come in here to convolution, open it up, click a real-time preview, pull it down. You see our image is normal. We're going to blur this image. Bam, all the way. Standard deviation, lower slider bar, all the way. And you're like, what? Why would I do that? Seriously, let's accept it because right now we want, this is our color data. This is not our structure data. It's not our detail data. This is not our fine focus data. This is our color data. And we want to help the luminance by getting rid of all that noise. And the best, quickest way to get rid of the noise and smooth the image out is to convolute it or blur it. Okay. So let's minimize the image. Let's bring in our luminance. Hey, luminance. So this obviously is still in a linear state. Hit F12, it dies. Hit F12 again, it comes back. Just previewed. So we want to do some linear noise reduction. So we're going to drag this little tab over here. We're going to drag it off. See that? Oh, we've made a copy. That's how quick you make a copy. And we're going to open up our histogram, our information tool, or reset it. And let's see, we're connected to the clone. So if we kill the auto stretch in that clone, and then we restretch, let's reset the tool. This is reset, we stretch. See right here, we want to create, this is the reason that we made this copy, is we want to create a mask that we're going to apply. We're going to protect the bright spots, leave the dark spots vulnerable, and we're going to apply nonlinear noise reduction. So in creating this mask though, we want good contrast between the bright and the dark. So if you take your mouse and you hover over the screen transfer, see how it turns to an arrow? Boop. If you come right here and point at those little carrots, or I think they're called carrots, I don't know, and you roll your mouse backwards, what happens is it's almost like zooming in. It gives you the ability to now make fine adjustments to those sliders. If I push that down like that, see, now I have more contrast, which is what I want in a mask, right? So I like that. I'm going to take that data, put it on the bottom of the histogram transformation, right? Kill the auto stretch in it. I'm going to take all that information, put it on top of the image. Now we're stretched. Minimize the tool. And same thing before, apply it as a mask. Let's minimize that mask. Put it right here. And we're going to come right click and we're going to go invert mask, right? We want to apply the noise reduction to the background, not the data, not the signal, but the background. So let's right click on it again, mask, show mask. The mask is still there. Why? Because our little tag info here is still brown. All right, so the tool we're going to use is multi-scale linear transform. And we're going to use it in the noise reduction. We have noise reduction checked. We have detail layer checked. It's bias. We're starlit transformation is our algorithm. And these are my settings. This is why I have all this stuff saved here. You're more than welcome to copy them down. But I found that applying noise reduction to the first four levels of just about any image cleans it up really good. To prove it to you though, let's create a little preview box. Let's click into the preview box. You see that there? So now let's drag over. Oh, and the target is set to luminance. Let's drag it over and see what it does to this little preview box. So yeah, good see. Smoothed it out. But it didn't apply any of that noise reduction to the image itself. That's the cool thing about the preview box is what it means. They apply a little box to your image. And so all your efforts are applied just to that. So it happens a lot faster than actually doing it to the whole image just to see what it does. So now that we like it though, we're going to drag it over, drop it on the image. All right, we're done. I mean, I can just see it right here. It looks better. So let's minimize that tool. Let's delete that preview. Let's right click on the image and say mask. And we're going to say show mat. No, we're going to say mask. And we're going to say remove the mask. We don't want it on. But guess what? Our data is still linear. We need to stretch it. So we're not going to use the mask stretch for that. We're actually going to use the histogram transformation tool to take the data from the screen transfer function and apply it to the image. So once again, let's reset the tool. Stretch it. Point at the little carrots. Roll your mouse back and let's roll back one more time. And now the more they roll it in, it's almost like zooming in. So you have fine adjustment abilities. Let's push that down right about there, somewhere in there. I like it. Drag it up, drop it on the image, hit F12. So that's our luminance data. All right, so now that we have our luminance done, we're going to open our image back up. Okay. And we're going to take this luminance data, we're going to apply it on top of the color data. And the tool we're going to use is LRGB combination. And that's what we use to combine them all. We're going to reset the tool. We're going to turn off red, green, and blue, and we're going to drag our luminance data over to the loom. Now, here's where this doesn't jump off the page, and it's very counterintuitive. I'm here to help. Because, dig it. If you want more saturation, you got to drop the slider down. If you don't want the image to be as bright, you got to push the slider up. Okay, so let's do this. Come in here. Let's go right here. We're going to create a preview box. We're going to click into the preview box so we can see what this happens real time. So let's drag this over and see what it does. Pretty cool. I like it, right? But still a little bright, and we could probably add some saturation. So let's pull it down and let's push it up. So we're adding saturation by bringing it down. We're darkening up the background by pushing the lightness up. Makes no sense. Let's drag it over, drop it on again. See the difference? Let's maybe do that one more time. Add a little bit more darkness, just a skosh more saturation. Drag it over, drop it on again. Okay, so I like that in the preview. And you see we've got some noise, because the more saturation that you add, the noisier the image gets. So we have this thing called chrominance noise reduction. We definitely want to have that checked, because it's actually going to use that luminance data to apply more noise reduction to the image. Okay, but we like it, so let's come back out. Let's apply it to the whole image. And then we wait. Good. All right. So, voila. All right. My work here is done. It looks like magic. It's like, whoa, it's like magic. All right. So let's minimize that. We don't need that tool. Yeah, I don't know what else to do. JPEG it. So yeah, we got a really good looking image, but we can do some work to it. We can create another luminance layer. You know, we really don't have to create it. We can use our luminance that we already had created, but let's just create one. So once again, counterintuitive, let's apply. Oh, we already applied it. We got distracted. So let's minimize. We got like a ton of mask right here, but that's cool. So let's close this preview box, delete it, and let's open up our curves transformation. And let's open up a real-time preview by clicking on that circle. We can lighten it up just a little bit. Let's get a little more contrast in it right there. Let's take that blue B component there, and we're gonna pull it down. See how that just pops a little blue in there? Ooh, and then let's add a little saturation, just a little bit. Ain't gotta add much. Let's click OK to that. And crack your neck. Wow. All right, let's kill it. So once again, let's do that same little trick. Let's right-click on the mask, go invert mask, open up a real-time preview. Let's click on RGB. And look at that, man. Like our background colors are really close together. Sometimes when you do that, I'm not fast enough. Sometimes you'll see like red and green. You'll see blue way the heck up here. That's a whole nother video. But right now our background looks really good. So let's anchor it. Remember? Point. Let's pull it down. Ooh. Let's accept it by hitting the square button. I like it. Let's minimize the tool. So our background is vulnerable, and that's good, because what I want to do is I want to do some non-linear noise reduction. So let's click a little preview box. It's coming right in here, right there. Click the preview. So we got some noise. Kind of overstretched our luminance a little bit, but that's fine. We'll clean that right up. Come in here to process. We're going to go down to noise reduction. And we're going to go to TGV denoise. I really like that tool, even though it takes a little while longer because it's running so many iterations, 100. I do like it. So first one, oh, sorry. We want to change that to the CIE to lab mode. We're going to do the lightness first. And we could probably push up the strength a little bit more. Let's increase the smoothness just a little bit, just purely to taste. Let's drag it over, drop it onto the preview. Let's see what it does. You can see down here, it's running through each step. So you see, it's kind of blending that in. I like it. This takes a little bit. So we're going to pause, but we're going to drop it on and we'll be right back. All right, we're at 98% and we're done. Okay. So let's go back in here to our preview. Let's go over here to the chrominance or color noise reduction. Let's do the same thing. Let's boost that strength up just a little bit. We're going to not worry about the edge protection, but we are going to boost the smoothness up just a little bit. Let's drag it over and see what it does. Zoom in here. Oh, I forgot to tell you guys, before and afters are performed with Control-Alt-Z. Control-Alt-Z, Z, Z, Z. Just keep hitting the Z button. So we're definitely smoothing that color noise out. And I mean, we're getting into a level that you can't see on Facebook. Let's drag it over and drop it anyway. And wait. And we're done. Okay. So background non-linear noise reduction, it's done. Let's do one thing before we switch this mask back out. Remember, our background is still vulnerable, but to me, it looks a little blue. Does it look blue to you? It could just be all this blue here. But let's say that you didn't like that blue. Let's say you wanted to kind of even that up. Guess how to do that. Come in here to histogram transformation. The background's still vulnerable. Let's reset the tool. And now you can see what our histogram's doing. You see that green has been pulled back because we use the SCNR. But look, our blue's just a little dominant. Just a little dominant. So we can click the blue, right? So it shows us what our blue's doing here, but it's tracking what we're doing to all three channels or the relationship that they each have, the RG and the B. So we can clip this blue just a little bit. You see how it brings it back? We can go way back like that. All right. So first, let's create a real-time preview so we can see what we're doing in real time. And let's just bring that blue back just a little bit. Right there. See how we kind of evened it up? Not so blue anymore, right? Got a nice kind of a neutral background color, which is what we want. We really want this blue in this in the nebulosity, the reflection nebula around the Pleiades here to stand out. So let's accept that. And we're going to minimize the tool. Let's close a real-time preview. I mean, we got an awesome image here. So let's go in here to mask. And we're going to invert the mask so our background is protected. Let's do another preview around these stars right here. We're just going to kind of tighten everything up. Let's click into the preview. All right. And we're going to sharpen things up by coming in here to process. We're going to come to convolution, and the opposite of convoluting or blurring something is to sharpen it. So unsharp mask. Who thought of these words, man? I swear. So let's default it. So yeah, it's pretty aggressive in the default. Let's bring it back to maybe 0.5. Let's drag it over and drop it on the image. Let's just zoom in here. Control Alt and Z. Can't tell. Going to be hard for you to tell, but it's just rounding out the stars a little bit. So with it on, with it off, with it on, with it off, it's subtle, but it does make a difference. So now we're going to go back to our image, drag it over, drop it on to the image itself. It's going to apply that sharpening. You can close that tool. Let's delete that preview. And honestly, with this, because we don't have a lot of nebulosity to do a lot of work to, let's remove the mask. I'm going to call this done. I've started using AI denoise. I would probably take it in there and maybe do a little more sharpening and noise reduction to it. But the main focus of this video was to show the mask stretch tool as an alternative way to stretch your RGB data. Narrowband? I haven't figured it out for narrowband. I've tried it. I still like to use the screen transfer function for narrowband data, but for RGB data, I mean, what I feel like is the combination of the mask stretch tool and LRG combination adjusting these sliders gives you really good looking image, lots of good color, but not overly saturated. So yeah, I hope this has been entertaining and informational at the same time. And my name's Steve. This is Entering Into Space. And as always, I'm wishing you clear skies and clear minds.
Well, you look good. You look so good, little skull and crossbones. Yes, you do.